Hello friends, how are you all? Welcome to my channel. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. My name is Priya and I make vlogs about travel, lifestyle in Germany and some easy peasy recipes. So if you are interested, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get the notifications and motivate me to make more videos for you. So as the title says, I am today going to discuss you the reasons why I am not able to leave Germany. I have tried many times from Germany to migrate to Australia, Belgium or even back to India, but every time we have to come back within months. And even visa office was wondering why you were not able to leave Germany, why you always keep on coming back. And today I will tell you the reasons why it is so. First reason is that Germany has spoiled me because of its good infrastructure system. In Germany, it is so easy to go from one place to another place that this infrastructure I am not able to get anywhere else in the world, especially in Asian countries or in Australia, you know. It's so difficult that we are just used to have very good trams, very good trains, very overspeed trains, you know, and safe, clean toilets, good parks for the children. Even wheelchair bound people have their own toilets or you know, space to go on the road, cycle friendly, good lakes, family friendly activities. All these things we are not able to get anywhere else. Either it is too expensive for us, or you know, if things are free, everybody is going on regular basis, swimming pools and everything. As a family, we need such type of activities, and when we are not able to get that type of infrastructure anywhere else, we come back to Germany. Second is location in Europe. Germany is in the middle of the Europe. So by road, I will not even say by flight, by road we can go to so many countries. Means by car, by bus, by trains, we can so easily go to so many countries. So even a weekend I can plan just so right away in Paris. It will not be difficult. So that is why, and as a family and my own personal nature, I'm very much travel enthusiastic. And if we are getting bored here in, you know, in this day-to-day mundane activities, we can just go anywhere else and have a change in our routine and refresh ourselves and come back to our home. Then the third main thing is low crime rate. Because here education is free, infrastructure is good, so people are generally happy and society is equal, as I said. So crime rate is also low. People don't feel jealous. They don't have to snatch money from the other person, or they don't feel, you know, the need of doing a crime. So that when the reason is not there, when the social inequality is not there, so I feel safe. Even at the midnight, I have come from the busy city center back to home without any problem, and I have walked to home, half an hour walk I have done without any problem. I was scared a little bit, but it was so good to walk. Nightlife is so good, nightlife is so safe, and streets are properly lit. So that is a safety which as a person I want. Education is free. You will think I'm money minded, that oh god, why she wants all things free, but it's not about that. For me, like, bad times, financial times can come in anyone's life, right? So especially during, we can see in this lockdown period, when I have that sense of security that my child will not be suffering from, you know, lack of education or something like that just because of lack of funds, I feel so safe and secure and sure. And then all other parents feel safe and secure. There is no, you know, in society there is no jealousy, there is no negativity. When this positivity is there, when our children's life is secure, safe, then we all feel positive, and then it reflects in the society, it reflects in the standard of living. Yes, we pay lots of taxes for all this security and safety, but then that's funds that text goes to each section of the society, to even the poor section of the society, so that no child is deprived of basic education. And then, as I said, government takes care of people. Government really takes care. If I, as a woman, because I also think about my daughter and my children, right, my son, that if as a woman is suffering from domestic violence, if as a man my husband is suffering from domestic violence, which you can be sure that I am not doing anything, and when you can be sure that I am not a victim of domestic violence, but suppose, God forbid, if something happens, if children are suffering from violence, they can go to police, they can go to the doctor, they can contact any person in the authority, and they have separate houses, separate, you know, accommodation for such people to give them a safe place, and then government takes up the matter and ensures that they are properly, you know, their accommodation is secured and they get accommodation and their life is secure. And if domestic violence is there, then husband is given restraint order or a wife is given restraint order so that the couple stays away and they are safe away from each other and kids are safe. So much taking care of the society I haven't seen anywhere else in the world. Like, and it is so easily accessible. It is not that information is not, nobody knows about this information. This information is given to everyone, easily accessible, so that no one suffers in silence. Mental health is also taken very good care of. If I tell my doctor that I am suffering from some mental stress, he will immediately take some action. It is not that, oh God, no, you are just, you know, going crazy. And medical leave, it's unlimited medical leave. If I get sick, I can get unlimited medical leave from my office. My doctor just have to write something, a note, and I will, obviously it will be not fake or just, there is no fraudulent such certificates, genuine ones. But if I'm really sick, for any reason, I will be allowed to stay home and recover, and my health insurance pays for that. And for me personally, as a person, the way I am, I really need a simpler life, and which I find only in Germany, that everyone wears the best clothes, they eat the best food, but just for themselves. They don't judge the other person's choices. If the other person is not eating organic or eating, you know, wearing branded clothes, they're not judged. Like some students I have seen, you know, going in broken shoes, broken bags, and nobody, you know, thinks, give a second thought about it, that it's okay. It's okay. Main thing is your own life, your own decisions, your own happiness. That I really like about it, that people live a very simple and very minimalistic things. Like if they need something, like if they need a BMW, they will buy a BMW, but because they will need it. It will not be bought just to flaunt or, you know, to make the neighbor jealous. They will buy because they want it. And it really, relieves the stress from a person. Then in society, there is no negativity. And when the whole thing is positive, and it really raises the standard of the living of people, standard of the happiness of the people. Then I will say the way they embrace history. You know, in Second World War, most of the Germany was destroyed. But still they restored it. They restored their historical attractions. And they also restored that the synagogues, which were, you know, the Jewish worship place, which were burnt by Nazis. You know, they have also dark history with Hitler, the way there were concentration camps, so many people were killed. And they don't shy away from that. They don't say that, no, we didn't do it. They accept it. They have shields. They have written, they are, you know, proper signboards saying that, yes, so many people were killed by Nazis. They don't shy from it. In history classes to the in the school, children are taught about it. As a newcomer in my German course, I was taught about it. They really taught why they teach. Even we, as a student, we asked our teacher, why you are teaching such type of thing? And we are supposed to have asked such type of questions. And she said, so that we Germans don't forget their history. And when they will not forget the history, they will not repeat the mistakes which they did. That is why in 2015, Germany was the foremost country which accepted so many refugees. Because they believe in humanity, they believe in helping people, and it really fascinates me. It makes me feel proud, and it makes me feel, you know, secure and safer. Now there are so many other things like here quality of food is very good and at considerably low prices, and their beer is very good, and their tourist attractions, places, sightseeing is very beautiful. Maybe you are seeing my travel vlogs, you can see the journey is so beautiful. But these things, I don't think they are so special about Germany. I've seen many countries also. There are many good touristic attractions, and food is great at some places. But yeah, here in Germany, I find that cost of living is a little bit on the lower side. But still, what makes me German more feel more special, it's just that the infrastructure, it is so easy to go from one place of attraction to the other place of attraction. And yeah, it's very, life is very beautiful here. So life is beautiful, it also doesn't mean that life is bed of roses here. Germany has its own challenges. They have their own problems, like all humans do, but that also makes life interesting. And when the life is positive overall in other aspects, education, medical facilities, and the community, then these challenges we can easily face it. That is why Germany was so good in fighting with this COVID-19 problem. Their death rates were low, and their active cases are also getting very low day by day. So that is why it makes me, I don't want to leave Germany, where medical facilities are so good, education facilities for my children are so good. As a family, we are very happy. But life is not bed of roses. I will not say that life is perfect here. No, Germany has its own challenges. But I wanted to share with you the reason why we are deciding not to leave Germany. If you agree with me, if you like the video, please hit the like button, share it with your family and friends, and write to me in the comment box the reason why you don't agree with me that maybe your country is better than Germany, or you think that these aspects in Germany are not that good. Share it with me. Maybe I will be more enlightened. I should also increase my area of knowledge. And do subscribe to my channel if you haven't done already. I will see you in my next video. Till then, take very good care of yourself. Stay healthy, stay happy, and stay blessed. Bye-bye.